फिक्सेशन अबव एंड 4 लेवल बिलो, 3 to 4 लेवल बिलो, टू अचीव अ गुड फिक्सेशन फॉर द फ्रैक्चर टू यूनाइट. सो दिस वॉज एट द सर्वाइको थोरेसिक जंक्शन विच इज अ वेरी हाई स्ट्रेस एरिया. आई डिड अ फिक्सेशन फ्रॉम C3 टू अराउंड T3, अ लॉन्ग सर्जरी. शी डिड एक्सट्रीमली वेल. आई कुड रिड्यूस द डिफॉर्मिटी एंड ऑल हर पेन डिसअपियर्ड आफ्टर दी सर्जरी. एंड आई थिंक इट इज ऑलमोस्ट 1 ईयर नाउ आफ्टर द सर्जरी. सी इज डूइंग वेल. बट अगेन यू हैव टू कंट्रोल मेडिकली हर इन्फ्लेमेशन टू प्रिवेंट दीज काइंड ऑफ फ्रैक्चर्स. कमिंग टू मेटाबॉलिक, विच इज अ वेरी कॉमन थिंग वी ऑल सी, ऑल दी आई टी इंडिविजुअल्स हु कम विद बैक पेन, नेक पेन, मिड बैक पेन, ऑल काइंड ऑफ पेन. दे यूजली हैव डेस्क जॉब्स. द पेन इज एक्शियल, इट इज क्वाइट डिफ्यूज, क्रॉनिक सिंस मेनी ईयर्स. मोस्टली अ जॉब ऑफ अ फिजियो, बिकॉज इफ यू डू ऑल देयर स्कैन्स आर नॉर्मल, ऑल इन्वेस्टिगेशन आर नॉर्मल. आई डोंट हैव मच टू डू अदर देन काउंसिलिंग, टेल देम टू डू फिजियोथेरेपी, मे बी सम विटामिन डी, D3, B12 सप्लीमेंटेशन. दे माइट हैव रेफर्ड पेन गोइंग डाउन द लिम्स, जनरलाइज टिंगलिंग नमनेस. यू ऑल माइट हैव सीन दीज काइंड ऑफ पेशेंट्स. नो न्यूरो डेफिसिट, नो लोकल टेंडरनेस, नो अलार्मिंग साइंस. ऑल यू नीड इज सम विटामिन डी 3 B12, सम पोस्चरल मॉडिफिकेशंस, अर्गोनॉमिक एडवाइस, सम एक्सरसाइजेस, दैट्स ऑल्सो. आई गेस दिस इज अ जॉब डन कंप्लीटली बाय फिजियोथेरापिस्ट रादर देन अ सर्जन. सो दीज मेटाबॉलिक पेन्स, वेर वी कॉल देम ऑस्टियो पेनिया, वेर देर इज वीकनेस ऑफ बोन ड्यू टू विटामिन डी 3 डेफिशंसी, ऑल वी हैव टू डू इज सप्लीमेंट विटामिन डी एंड स्ट्रेंथन देयर मसल्स वेर दे कैन सिट फॉर प्रोलॉन्ग पीरियड एट वर्क. सो इट्स ऑल अप टू यू टू ट्रीट देम. कमिंग टू ट्रॉमा, ट्रॉमा इन स्पाइन इज नॉट वेरी एनकरेजिंग, बिकॉज इफ अ पेशेंट डेवलप्स अ न्यूरो डेफिसिट लाइक पैराप्लेजिया, क्वाड्रिप्लेजिया एट द टाइम ऑफ इंजुरी, द चांसेस ऑफ रिकवरी आर यूजली नॉट वेरी ब्राइट. सो दे हैव टू लर्न टू लिव विद दैट पैराप्लेजिया और क्वाड्रिप्लेजिया, विच इन माई एक्सपीरियंस इन द लास्ट 10 ईयर्स इज ऑलमोस्ट एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट इन अ कंट्री लाइक इंडिया. वी डोंट हैव गुड रिहैब सेंटर्स एंड देयर लाइफ इज एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट. सो आई वुड एनकरेज एनी ऑफ यू हु आर स्टिल यंग टू टेक अप रिहेबिलिटेशन ऑफ क्वाड्रिप्लेजिक्स एंड पैराप्लेजिक्स. आई हैव हैड मेनी पेशेंट्स हु हैव कम विद फॉल, रोड ट्रैफिक एक्सीडेंट्स. यंग पेशेंट्स एज यंग एज 25-30 ईयर्स ऑफ एज, दे डेवलप क्वाड्रिप्लेजिया, पैराप्लेजिया एंड देयर लाइफ इज एक्सट्रीमली डिफिकल्ट. देर इज नो वन टू टीच देम रिहेबिलिटेशन. देर नो गुड फिजियोज हु कैन डू अ रिहैब इन अ पैराप्लेजिक और क्वाड्रिप्लेजिक. I know of a center in Delhi where they do good job, and then in the armed forces, AFMC, the Khadki unit, MH Khadki, they have a good rehab team. But otherwise, in civil practice, I have hardly found anyone who can do good rehab for these patients. So, I'd encourage you guys to take up rehab of paraplegics and quadriplegics. It's not only for me, even for all our spine surgeons in Pune here or anywhere in India, it's a big challenge to manage these patients. We are in the lookout for good physios who can help us rehabilitate these patients, help them get functionally active. So in these patients, like you can see in the slide, they might have variable neuro deficit right from complete deficit, which has a poor prognosis, to mild deficit or incomplete deficit, which has a good prognosis of recovery. Now, usually lumbosacral spine, like if it's a back pain or if it's the lumbar vertebra which is fractured, it's usually the nerve roots which are there in the lumbar spine. The cord ends at the level of D12 L1. So if it's a lumbar spine trauma, usually even with complete deficit, the prognosis is quite good. I've had a patient who had a fall from fourth story of a building while he was painting. He had complete deficit with bowel bladder involvement, but his fracture was at the L2 level. So the cord was not there. It was the nerve roots. I could decompress, push the bony fragments anteriorly, and fix the spine. And at 3 months, surprisingly, he came walking to me. All his neuro deficit, bowel bladder involvement had recovered. So in the lumbar spine, the fracture and the neurodeficit has a good prognosis. Time of intervention usually doesn't matter. It's not that if a patient gets paraplegia and you operate on day one, they will recover. It's not like that. There are many scientific papers on this which do show us that time of intervention doesn't matter much in these cases. And as I told you, the role of a physiotherapist is extremely important. I also do these sacral fractures, which are a part of the spine. So this patient was a young lady with a very bad injury. She was traveling in a bullock cart and a tempo dashed their bullock cart at full speed. And when she came to our hospital, she was almost about to die because it's a pelvic injury. Anteriorly, you can see that it's an open book kind of injury. The anterior pubic symphysis is all fractured. There is a fracture at the acetabular level, and there is a posterior vertically unstable sacral fracture, which is a type 3 kind of a fracture, the most unstable injuries. So she was hemodynamically unstable. We first stabilized her hemodynamically. We applied an external fixator to the pelvic injury so that her blood loss stopped and she became stable with few blood transfusions. And then we decided to do the posterior sacral fracture, the sacroiliac joint dislocation, wherein we applied traction, reduced it, and put this one screw. You might feel that it's just one screw posteriorly, but to put that screw is extremely difficult because the anatomy of the pelvis, as you know, is very complicated. We do prefer putting two screws like that, but her sacroiliac joint region was quite narrow and the channel to put is very narrow, that you have just area of 2 centimeter, a distance of 2 centimeter within which your screw should go. If it goes slight anteriorly, it will damage the S1 root, and if it goes posteriorly, it will damage the L5 root. So it's a very narrow zone through which you have to put the screw, and we were able to put this one screw. But fortunately, she did well even after this, and this was the X-ray at around 3 months, where we could remove the external fixator. Her anterior injury was quite stable by that time and the posterior screw was holding well. So she overall did well. But these are extremely difficult and dangerous fractures. Again, a very bad fracture. A 40-year-old lady in the city of Pune was traveling on a two-wheeler and she was hit by a truck coming from behind. And she had a fracture dislocation of the thoracolumbar spine. This is a complete dislocation. You can see that the spinal cord is completely squashed there. Complete paraplegia. No chances of recovery. We told her before surgery. We did it immediately. She came and within 12 hours of surgery, we had done this surgery. But again, the prognosis is very bad. We could reduce the fracture completely. You don't see the fracture dislocation after the surgery. I could completely reduce it. Fixed the spine. Now here I would like to mention the role of the physiotherapist. We have a physio, only one I know of in Pune, who does extremely good rehab for these paraplegics and quadriplegics. He has a very good setup. I think his name is Gajanan. I don't know his last name. But he looked after this lady so well that now, in spite of the paraplegia, she is able to stand on her feet and walk with all the braces and a lot of core strengthening. And she had slight power in her gluteal muscles, which he exploited and strengthened her gluteal muscles. So with the help of a walker and with braces for her knee and ankle, she's able to swing her leg and walk. That's a very gratifying thing for the lady who has a small kid and she's able to slightly ambulate in her house. So she did not have any neurological recovery, but with excellent rehab, she is able to at least stand on her feet, though it is with support, but she is able to stand on her feet, which is a huge job, very big job. And this took almost 3 to 6 months. So there is the role of good rehabilitation. And I, as a surgeon, can only stabilize the spine. This rehab part is to be done by you guys. Coming to emergencies and urgencies, where you must refer it to a surgeon rather than waiting. So, what are the clinical symptoms where you should refer? Is one is severe and progressive pain. No matter what you do, if the patient's pain is bad and it is going on progressing, I would recommend you refer these patients for an opinion. They might do some investigations, MRIs, rule out anything serious. The patient might come back to you, but at least you are safe that you're not unnecessarily wasting time. Then gross or progressive neurodeficit. You should definitely refer them. If they have grade 1, 2 power, you should not fiddle around. You should immediately refer them to a surgeon. If they have a progressive deficit, like if when they came to you, they had grade 4 plus power, and gradually it became grade 3 plus, grade 3, you should definitely refer them before it worsens further. If they have constitutional symptoms, let's say a patient comes with back pain, but along with that, if the patient is looking pale, he has got fever, or he has got evening temperature, he has got night pains, he has got some deficit, he has got loss of appetite, loss of weight, you should always refer these patients to rule out anything serious. Again, progressive deformity. Let's say you have a patient with scoliosis and you are managing with brace, some exercises, but you find that every 3 monthly x-ray you do and his deformity seems to progress. I know of some physiotherapists who can measure Cobb's angles and they do give bracing to deformity patients. So if you measure the Cobb's angle and it's progressing every 3 monthly, you should always refer them for an opinion from a surgeon. They might require fixation of the deformity. Again, bowel bladder deficit. If the patient is unable to pass urine, if he goes to urine and he has a sensation of incomplete evacuation, they might not tell you incomplete evacuation. They might say that it's a problem of I have to go frequently to urinate. So then it might indicate that he is not evacuating it completely the first time. So he has to again and again go for passing urine. He or she. And again, a bladder deficit is a problem in these patients where they might have compression of the spinal nerves either in the cord or in the lumbar spine. They might be developing cauda equina symptoms. So always refer these patients, rule out anything serious. All they might have is an old person with some prostate problem and his bladder symptoms may not be related to his back pain, but still it's better to be safe in cauda equina, because the earlier you operate, the better are the results. Once the bladder deficit becomes complete, the chances of recovery are very bad. I know patients of cauda equina who have recovered from their motor and sensory deficit. They are ambulant on their legs, but their bladder deficit hasn't recovered. It's a pathetic lifestyle for these patients, because for the external world, they are normal, they are walking, they are doing all their activities. But every eight hourly throughout their life, they have to self-catheterize themselves and evacuate the bladder. The bladder sphincter just doesn't relax. That's the problem with cauda equina and the bladder deficit. There is retention. They will not be able to pass urine on their own. They have to pass a urinary catheter every 8 hourly and evacuate their bladder, which you can imagine is an extremely sad symptom to live with. Extremely bad. They have to carry their catheters at work. They have to self-catheterize themselves. You can imagine it's a very bad life. There are people who ask us that we prefer to be paraplegics, but please help us recover our bladder and bowel. And unfortunately, we can't do anything. So bladder bowel deficit, always refer them to a surgeon before it is too late. Again, unsteady gait, tendency to fall can indicate that there is some cord compression. Always refer these patients and get an MRI done to rule out any cervical or thoracic cord compression. Localized hyperreflexia and or clonus, like I explained in my clinical symptoms topic day before yesterday. So these indicate some serious cord compression. You should. Okay. So that's what we are covering for today. And again, I would like to invite any questions from today's topic or from the topic which was there or day before yesterday. We have plenty of time today, so we can invite many more questions. I have tried to finish it on time today so that we can entertain your questions more.